Hi, this is Simon, and this is part one of a series on data bending and data moshing with audio. Everything inside of our computer or any other digital system is made up of numbers. All of the videos you watch on streaming services, all of the music that's on your computer or iPod, all of the photos that are stored in your phone, those are all built on numbers, on data. When we're online, data is also constantly collected about us in order to target individuals for advertising or political messages. Many of these things happen without our thought or our knowledge of it. But by making art with data, by bending and distorting that data, we can create some sort of post-digital expression, forefronting technology and its imperfections, and making a kind of glitch art. In data bending, we take the data of one type of media file and open it or distort it with another type of media file. For example, opening a Word doc with an audio editor. In data moshing, we embrace the expressive possibilities of compression artifacts. And in digitally mediated culture, we're probably most familiar with this effect in video, both intentional and unintentional. In this video, I'm going to show you a very, very simple way to get started using the free software Audacity. You can download it from the Audacity website, audacityteam.org. Let's get started. Audacity is a waveform editor, which means it shows us graphs of sound that we can interact with and edit visually. Left to right is time, up and down is amplitude. Rather than open up an audio file to edit, though, we're going to bring in some files that aren't audio, data bending. What we're going to do today is really just a one-step process. I'm going to go up to File, Import, Raw Data. I've cherry-picked a few files that I found had good results in data bending. I found that JPEGs and PNG files don't give us so much variety. Let's start by using this vocoder.ens. ENS is a reactor file. Then open. We get a window that asks us about importing raw data, and we have a few settings that we can set here. First is the encoding. What kind of file do we want to try to bring this in as? It's worth keeping in mind, though, that we're importing raw data, and our goal is to have data bent noise. So feel free to experiment with all these settings. CD quality audio is 16 bits, so I'm going to start by bringing something in as a 16-bit PCM, pulse code modulation, and so WAV files and AVE files are in this format. The byte order is not going to matter because we're importing raw data. This affects the order of how Audacity brings in that file, but I'm just going to leave this as little endian. The number of channels here might be important, though, depending on whether you want a stereo or a mono file. We'll leave this at 2. Start offset is if we want to skip some of the data in the file. We'll leave that at 0 for now. Amount to import, if you want to bring in a gigantic file, maybe you don't want to import the whole thing, maybe you only want to do the first 10% or something. And we can also choose our sample rate. CD quality, again, 16 bits, 44.1 kilohertz. So this 44.1 setting would give us CD quality audio. Then import. One very important thing before we press play here, make sure you've turned down your speakers or headphones a bit, because this promises to be a little bit loud. Just doing Command A to select the whole thing and spacebar to play. Now that's an interesting sound. It's noisy, but it varies over time and it has some dynamicism to it. I'm going to try a different file. File, import, raw data. I have a couple PSD files. These are Photoshop document files, and I found that they're pretty interesting too. I won't mess with my settings and go import. This brought it in as a second track. I'm just going to close that original one. This one, wow, look at that, is significantly longer too. Let's listen to a bit of this. Let me jump to the end here. Now that has some fantastic changes over time. Let's try one more. I'll close this first this time. Import. Raw data. Let's do another PSD file. This BMP is a bitmap file. Let's open that. Let's do it mono again. Let's do 16 bits. tune that a bit. Some of you might be thinking, this is awful. This is everything we're trying to avoid in recording, which is a fair comment. But keep in mind, we're now embracing this noise and trying to think of how we might use it expressively. Artists like Tone Yasunao made music using live distortions of CDs, actually glitching CDs in real time. And a famous noise artist, Merzbow, described his work saying, if music was sex, Merzbow would be pornography. He goes on, I mean that pornography is the unconsciousness of sex, so noise is the unconsciousness of music. Whether or not you agree, there are a lot of possible uses for these sounds. I use a Databend Kima file as a background at the end of my piece, Kitsune no Mado. And if that's still a little out there for you, with a little editing, we can use this noise for super lo-fi drum beats. For example, let's look at the beginning of this file. I'm going to zoom in. If you're interested in doing more with sample editing, I got a video where I talk about that. That sound could be a high percussive sound, a hi-hat or a snare maybe. So let's take that and we'll go Command C to copy it, Command N to make a new file, Command V to paste that. I'm not going to do my usual super clean editing because we don't need to do that with this kind of file. So I'm going to go export, export as wave. Make a folder for these, glitch drums, hi-hat. I don't need to add any metadata. And so now I'm going to Command W to close this. And let's find some other sounds. Okay, there we go. Command C, Command N, Command V. Let's go File, Export as Wave. Let's call that one our snare. Then last but not least, let's find a kick. Command C, Command N, Command V. File, export, it's wave, kick. So here I have those files. Of course, you could put these into a sampler, set them up in your DAW or even Audacity. But in the interest of keeping everything in this video free, I'm going to use a simple sampler that I made in Pure Data here. If you want to learn how to make something like this, I've got a series of videos on Pure Data that you can check out. Basically, this is just a sequencer, and then I can send out. Triggers. Yeah, that's pretty hectic. I could slow this down a bit too. That's pretty neat. Moving forward, we'll build on these ideas of manipulating data for audio expression. And keep working with free tools, embracing a punk mindset.